Hi, this is a Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about why you should consider creating an app framework instead of just creating an app. Okay, so this week I want to talk about frameworks. Now we released an app this week called French Flash Quiz, which took us just a few days to develop. It was fantastic. And the reason it took a few days to develop is because we've already done much of the work with the last application. So a few weeks ago, we released Algebra Study Cards, which is a quiz game, which, you know, lightning fast, it generates algebra questions and you have to answer them very quick. I'm really, really very proud of it. However, it took a bit longer to create because we weren't thinking in terms of we're just going to do this one app. It was in terms of we're going to build an app framework. So yeah, we wanted to build a framework that we could use to create other apps, other similar apps of the same way. So to give you an idea of what I mean, we talk about if you're going to develop a single app, say for iPhone, what you get is you get a diagram like this over here. So it's like, you know, basically all phones are and all computers are, everything is just hardware. So it's, you know, it's ones and zeros, everything flying through. You know, if you're a hardware guy, you don't think in terms of operating systems, or you think about, you know, how the operating system handles telling the camera to take a picture, and say one phone might be different from another phone, so that code might be different. So that's where the operating system comes in. Like iOS is an operating system, Android is an operating system. And what that does is gives a consistent interface to say every time it takes a picture, depending on which device it is, you know, just call this function and the operating system will handle how to implement all that. So that's fantastic. That's an operating system. And then your code, of course, sits on top of that operating system and you write your native code. Now, the problem with that is that if you do like more than one, like if you do Android and iPhone, then you have two sets of code, which sits on two different operating systems. Our early apps were like that. And it's, you know, it's a pain. It's like every time we update something, we have two different skill sets to somebody to go through and make changes. So the more over the past year and a half, we've been using mostly hybrid frameworks, mostly Corona SDK. However, lately we're using the Ionic framework. And what that does is that these frameworks, these Ionic frameworks, what they do, or Ionic framework, Cordova, Corona SDK, what they'll do is they'll take something like, I want to take a picture, right? And what they'll say is, to take a picture, just pass in this code or call this command, and the framework will handle checking if it's iPhone, then it's this. If it's Android, then it's this. So basically you're writing one set of code, and it's much more simple to write that code. However, it does introduce some restrictions. So like if there was a way that iPhone took a picture that you wanted to use, ideally, most likely you would not be able to do that because it's other platforms don't do it. So it makes things much more simple, but it makes it much more cost effective and easier to produce. So for our last app, what we've done for this framework that I was telling you about, what we've done is we created our own framework, which sits on top of another framework. So this is the Overpass way of doing things. So it's not specific to one app, but it might be, well, for us, it's the way we handle leaderboards, or the way we handle displaying buttons, the way we handle analytics, things like that. The kind of thing that we want to be able to put into every application, but we don't want to have to code it every single time. We don't want to just say, I'm just going to copy this and move it over to there. Ideally, what we want to do is build a framework and think of things in a modular way. Now, this takes longer than just doing the app, but in the long run, like I said, it took 6 weeks to do Algebra Study Cards. It took 5 days to do French Flash Quiz, and it's taking 2 days to do Mandarin Flash Quiz. So in the long run, it really helps out. And building on that kind of model, if you're thinking in that way when you're producing your app or your app portfolio, you may even do other layers of, like, say, for quiz games, we have this, which sits on top of the Overpass framework, which sits on top of the hybrid framework, and that. So what we have is we're only concerned with the code that's unique to each game. And it could be parameters, it could be configuration, or it could be things that are just, you know, different for each application. You know, they can't all be the same. Otherwise, you know, why even do them? So that's what it is. So if you're producing a portfolio of apps like we have, I would suggest that you start thinking about producing a framework. So it's difficult if you don't have your own developers to do this, or if you don't have somebody you work really well with. Because a lot of times, in my experience, when you're creating a framework, it's hard for even the developers to see what the framework's capable of until the second or third version of the application that you actually produce. And they say, ah, hey, let's change this in the framework. And the framework's always evolving. You know, you may say, for this game, we need this, but you know, that would be good in the other ones too. So you go through and change that. So I hope that makes sense. Doing things in a modular format is just a way that experienced developers know all about, but somebody who's just new to the app market might not be too familiar with. So that's it for this week's Minute of Overpass. Now, if you're watching this on iTunes through the podcast, please leave a review. I'd love to know what you think. And if you're watching this on YouTube or LinkedIn or Facebook, please leave a comment. I'd love to know what you think as well. That's it for this week. I'll talk to you next week.